In this video, I'll show you some of Crossword Compiler's generative AI tools for writing theme word lists and writing clues. Let's start by making a freeform vocabulary puzzle. So after choosing a size, I'll make a standard 15 by 15 puzzle here. You can either enter the words you want to use one of the supplied theme word lists, or you can click Generate List to use generative AI to generate a new list of words with any theme that you like. So all you need to do is describe the theme in plain English in the box. So let's say I wanted to write a puzzle about mountain plants. I could put that in. I can choose a maximum length or change the number of words, but the default should work fine. Click Generate, which will then contact the language model and it will produce some words that you can use. You should always check the results, of course, produced by any of these generative tools. If there's anything you don't like here, you can edit them or add other words as you please before you start, and then click Build Puzzle and it will build the puzzle just as it would with any other word list. Once you like a fill that it's found, click the Accept button and you've now got your filled grid but without any clues. You could then go and write your own clues, or you can use the clue generator on the clue menu to write the clues for you. So here on the right you've got the list of the words that are in the puzzle. You can deselect some if you don't want it to generate clues for those. Here I'm going to try and write clues for all of them. You can change the clue style. There's a bunch of options to choose from here. You can also change the language or any special instructions. So just click Generate. It takes a little bit longer because it's generating slightly more material. And you'll see that it's generated clues. It's failed to write clues for a couple of specific clues here. If you want to have to get it to try again on some other clues, you can click Redo Unchecked. Or if you don't like a clue, so maybe you thought this one was a little bit too long, you could uncheck that and click the Redo Unchecked button, and it would then try again to fill in the clues. So again, AI generation is not 100% reliable, so you should check what you've got here, and you can redo things until you are happy with the result. You can also double click on a clue to generate a set of alternatives. So here it's generated a bunch of alternative clues for the word that you selected. So I could replace that and I've now got a different clue for Heather. Once you're happy with the results, you can check the ones you want to use. If you want to not use some of them, you can uncheck them. Then just use clues to use the complete set of clues. You can check that they've then appeared in the review edit clue list here. So once you've checked them, you can also regenerate them if you need to by right-clicking and selecting Generate Clues, and it'll generate again a set of possible alternative clues for any given word. You can also generate clues for a standard puzzle. So if you fill a grid using a standard word list, so here I'm just going to fill with the default word list, you can then again use the clue generator to write the clues for all the words in the grid. So again, we have the complete set of written clues here. If you want to fine-tune how the clues are generated, write your special instructions in here. For example, you might want to have a literature theme, so you could write clues should be literature themed. Generate clues, and you should then find that it tries to angle the clues to take in a literary perspective. You can also use the tools to generate puzzles in different languages. So I could put, instead of mountain plants, common food words in Spanish for 15 to 16 year old school children learning Spanish. Generate, and they will then generate the list in Spanish as well. So we've got common words for things like salad, hamburgers, ice cream, and so on in Spanish. Build the puzzle. Accept when it's got one of the puzzles you like the selection of words on. Perhaps we'll go for that one. And then you can use the clue generator as usual to write the clues. So you might want to change the style of the clues here. You might want to do a direct translation. If you're doing this in the US, you might want to change to American English, generate, and then you have the direct translation clues for learning Spanish. It doesn't have to be in English. You can do it in any other of the languages that you like. So I could do it into Hindi. The languages listed here are the ones that are most reliable, because they have the largest amount of training data, but you can also just type in another language here. So if you wanted clues in Ukrainian, you can just type in Ukrainian into this box and it will generate clues. We might find that they're slightly less reliable if we're using a language with a slightly smaller user base. If you prefer to take more control over the clue generation process, so I can click on the AI clue generator button here to bring up the clue generator, which will generate a set of possible words that you could use to clue moving picture. So here you can use clue, and it will insert it into the grid. You can go through the puzzle by clicking use and next, which will move on to the next clue and show you a set of possible clues you can use for the next clue. Select ones that you like and go through the grid, choosing each clue in turn. And of course you can change the instructions or the style and things here, or regenerate as necessary. If you don't like any of the generations, you just click it again and get a different set to choose from. Finally, with the Pro Grid Filler, you can also use the generator with the Fit Theme Words feature here. So the Fit Theme Words feature takes a list of theme words and then tries to fit them into a grid, which you can then build around to build your thematic puzzle. So again, there's the theme list generator here. Then I can type in the description of my theme for this puzzle. So let's say I wanted to generate something themed on War and Peace characters, generate, and it will insert a list of possible War and Peace characters. Again, you can edit these if you want to. Click OK. If it can't find a fit, you can edit the list. Let's try those three instead, and then you can view the possible layouts of the words. From this point on, you can just continue and fill around the grid. As you would normally. You can then write the clues as before. So for here, I might want to write things in a international literature theme, generate clues, because this is a large puzzle, it's made and taken a little bit longer. So you can see again, it has failed to generate a couple of the clues, but most of them, you have something to work from. Notice at the bottom here it says the quota remaining. When you buy the program, you get some fixed quota per year of clues you could generate, which is enough for most people to generate dozens of puzzles. But if you need more, you can always buy additional quota from the website. Here I've bumped up my quota, so I've got enough to make 814 puzzles. By default, you'd have enough to make 50 to 100 to 150, depending on what size of puzzle that you're making. So that's it for this video. Have fun playing with the AI generative tools. For example, here's a rhyming puzzle where the answer words are all words relating to poetry and the words are all in iambic trimeter and rhyming with each other. So there's all sorts of fun things that you can do. It's just up to you to play and experiment with what works and to regenerate things if you don't like them. Hope you enjoyed the video.